Thank you very much, Gordian. As we get ready for the second match of this doubleheader at St. Elizabeth Technical High School. The Manning School having a grand time so far in the competition. Monroe College have had great success at this venue already this season in a live television game and would love to repeat that this afternoon. There's the updated table. The Manning School leading with 6 points ahead of Monroe College on 4. The winner here today will advance to the Da Costa Cup semi-final. If the match ends in a draw, Mannings will be in the Da Costa Cup semi-final. Vere Technical will play the Ben Francis knockout Happy Grove out of it. The Manning School and Monroe College, M&M, battling for a place in the Da Costa Cup semi-finals. It's been a long time since they have been there. What an opportunity this is. Will they make use of it? First, the national anthem. Shamar Hamilton. The man, the captain of Manning School, Sean Kenyon, the captain of the Monroe College team, the two number 10s. Well, let's have a look at the starting lineups then, starting with the Manning School. Ashawnee Campbell will be in goal. Q Williams, Javin Williams, Abina Wallace, a former, well, his brother played for Sets formerly, Jamara Hall, Shamar Hamilton, Rashawn Graham, a former Sets man, Devonta Rodney, Shantuan McIntosh, Jamalik Porter, and Jordan Mailer. They are coached by Charles Tomlinson. They're playing a 4-1-3-2 formation. Mannings High. And Monroe College, Henry James will be in goal. Rasheem Neal, Javon Sharia, Javon Lewis, Devon Fletcher, Sean Kenyon. Watch the 19-year-old. He's impressive. Tristan Ford, Javoni Foster, Sian Faulkner, Amaria Morris, and Daniel Bowen. Patrick, Jackie Walters is their head coach. 3-5-2 is what Monroe College will be going in with. Also look out for Sian Faulkner with 5 goals. He'll be a great partner for Sean Kenyon. Mannings Monroe for a place in the Da Costa Cup semifinals. And we're away. Mannings have won both their matches in the quarterfinal round of the competition so far. 3-2 over Bear Technical, 6-0 over Happy Grove. Monroe College had a 4-3 victory over Bear and a 1-0 draw with Happy Grove. But they know if they can win today, that will seal it. The Manning School only need a draw to advance to the semifinals of this competition. Coach Patrick Jackie Walters has been in these situations many times before. Devonta Rodney on the attack for the Manning School. Rodney with a lovely cross and a chance for Jamelik Porter, who was twisting and turning and twirling, but couldn't get his body in the right position to turn the ball towards goal. I don't think he could make up his mind what he wanted to do. Young Porter, 5 goals so far this season. Ended up with his back to goal, where he probably would have wanted to have opened up his body to take the ball or turn with it. Good start here for Manning. Poor pass from Porter. And now they lose out to Giovanni Foster. Foster looking for Faulkner. Faulkner under pressure, won by Javin Williams. And Manning's go the other way, over the top. Asking for Rodney to run onto it. He won't get there. Comes out to Rashawn Graham. Cross headed away by Fletcher for Monroe. And now it goes forward for Faulkner. Faulkner has possession. One man to beat. He can't beat him. Retains possession though, the big, tall Faulkner. Then gives it away. Picked up in midfield by Jamara Hall. Hall. Abina Wallace. Devonta Rodney. Javon Lewis. Staying close. Rodney skips around his man. Rodney gets the cross in, held away. Lovely start here for the Manning School. Rashawn Graham. Too much weight on that from the former St. Elizabeth Technical player. Transferred to Manning's in 2019. Charles Tomlinson is the man in charge of the Manning School. And what a fabulous job he's done with them this season. They were brilliant in the opening round, where they topped Zone B ahead of former champions Froome Technical. And then in the second round so far, they have been impressive. Scored 18 goals in the first round, Chris, and conceded just 4. And they have already scored 9 in the second round, conceding just 2. We're looking at one of the highly fancied Da Costa Cup teams this season, the Manning School.
And they haven't lost yet this season. That's the important stat. 0 losses. And as you said, some 7 wins, just 1 draw.
McIntosh has it for them. Lifts it forward. Kenyon cleans up for Monroe. Was looking for Devon Fletcher. Manning. The shot from Porter blocked. Oh, ball almost given away there to Giovanni Foster. Faulkner comes forward to assist. Faulkner has possession. Faulkner is thinking about the shot. Goes for the shot, but not enough power behind him. But the first shot on target for Monroe College. First shot on target for the match.
7-time champions Monroe College haven't lifted the Da Costa Cup since 1964. If that's not a long drought, I don't know what is. Got to the final in 2000 before losing to Cornwall College, man. It was 4-1 at Jarrett Park. That's the last time that Monroe have really shown a lot of quality and gotten deep into the La Costa Cup. Manning showing a lot of quality here. They have the skillful Devontae Rodney on the football. Wins a throw. Do remember that this is a man's team as well that did get to the quarter-final round in 2019, so there have been a bit of consistency. And you talk about Monroe College not being in the final since 2000. It's been a long time they haven't won. If there's a man who can get them to the promised land, it's this one. Patrick Jackie Walters has been doing it from 1981 with Capredon in the Manning Cup. He's done it with Glenmuir. He's done it with Clarendon College. He's done it. So many teams. And now Monroe College want a piece of the pie. Can he deliver it to them? He's been at Monroe for a while now as well. Some would think that it's been a long time for him not to win a title. For sure. And we look at Fletcher committing the infringement on Jamara Hall. Free kick coming up for Manning. Here's an opportunity. Can't get the header towards the target. Will be picked up by Devontae Rodney. Can't get to it before it rolls into touch. Has a throw though, Rodney. Good start to this game. And you can already see the quality in this Manning's team. Monroe College have already had at least one big picture on this ground this season, Chris. A 2-1 triumph over St. Elizabeth Technical in the opening round. That went a long way in helping them through a difficult first round group that included St. Elizabeth Technical and also BB Court, the reigning Ben Francis Cup champions. And they'll be looking for another big victory this afternoon. And Manning has a free kick coming up. Of course, the Fair Boys and lastly those from Happy Grove may stay back to watch this contest. There's Kenyon, the number 10 for Monroe College. Free kick. Headed away. Good defending. Devontae Rodney, the number 12 for Manning, is going to be a handful this afternoon for Monroe. He's only scored one goal this campaign, but has 4 assists to his credit.
Yeah. They've been very inconsistent, Monroe College, this season. You mentioned that tough St. Elizabeth group. Don't forget a team called and a school called Laconia.
For sure.
They lost twice to them. Monroe, their other loss came at the hands of BB Cork, who, as you mentioned, are the 2019 are defending champions of the Ben Francis Cup. But as I said, they started out the season with a loss to Laconia. Then 4 games in a row they won, Monroe, and then 2 losses. So their performances just haven't been able to keep up good performances.
Oh, here is Rodney again. There's a shot coming in. And it turned out to be a good clearance from Rasheem Neal. But the Monroe defense will have their hands full. Here is Devontae Rodney. He will cause problems this afternoon.
Yeah. Conceded quite a bit this season. Some 11 goals they've conceded, Monroe, from their 9 matches. So Manning will be looking at that and definitely licking their lips.
Ball over the top, looking for Devon Fletcher. Fletcher gets there for Monroe College. Tries to go for the shot early. No success.
free kick coming up. Rashawn Graham, the man in number 11, taken down. Here he is, transferred from St. Elizabeth Technical to Mannings in 2019. Has scored 3 goals this season. Has 5 assists to his credit as well. Heading forward with Germany Porter. And a goal kick coming up for Monroe. Kenyon almost got caught out there. Monroe in possession. No real clear-cut opportunities yet, but it's been a lively start to the game. This is Sean Kenyon. Shavaya there for Monroe. Looking for Foster up front. Of course, once again, Monroe College not starting Zafir Bruce. He could make a big impact off the bench. Shamar Hamilton picks it up for Manning. Tightly marked though by Daniel Bowen. News coming in from around the island. After 90 minutes, William Nibb 2, Christiana 3. William Nibb disappointing in the quarterfinal round of the competition, so no Ben Francis knockout for them. Very disappointing considering they won their group and a difficult Zone A, losing all 3 matches in the quarterfinal round. So Christiana snubbing that Ben Francis spot. Big game this, really big game. Jontuan McIntosh. Javin Williams. Ball inside looking for Porter. Goalkeeper. Henry James got there first. Another big game going on in Manchester. Edwin Allen 0, Dintil 0. That's another blockbuster. For sure. The winner of that to go through to the semi-finals. Action. Edwin Allen have to win. Dintil can go forward with a draw, similar to Manning's. Both those teams, though, locked on 6 points, but Dintil a superior goal difference. take it in turn. We'll try and keep you updated as much as possible from the encounter. Dintel, Edwin Allen. Dintel trying to reach yet another Da Costa Cup semi-final. They have been so consistent in the last 6-7 seasons. And they'd love to be there again. Porter trying to break free for Manning. Connell College managing to get the ball away from danger for now. Rashawn Graham. McIntosh. Played forward by Wallace. Henry James on the scene. Always a lovely place for football, St. Elizabeth Technical High School. Rodney. Oh, Rodney does brilliantly. And so does the goalkeeper. Devonte Rodney. Showing his quality. Good pace by Rodney. Good close ball control. That's why he's such a dangerous player, Rodney. He's only scored once so far this season, but certainly his pace in the wide areas has been an asset for Mannings. Henry James has been solid so far. He's had to be, and will need to be for the rest of this. There is Sean René Francois Delano, St. Aubin Kenyon. That was a mouthful. He is a handful at his best. Will want to impact this game. 5 goals this season for the Monroe captain in that central midfield role, such a key one. Had a tremendous game against St. Elizabeth Technical here, where he dropped back into more of a defensive midfield role. Versatile player, there he is, Kenyon. This might just be their toughest match yet, who knows?
Yeah.
High riding Manning's team, yet to lose this season, on the front foot, very confident, goals from all over the park. Abina Wallace, that will be one of them.
Yeah, definitely won't be.
He's packed it over the top. Abina Wallace's older brother actually represented St. Elizabeth Technical in the Da Costa Cup before moving on to Manning's for sixth form. And now Abina representing the Manning School. Manning School in Savannah Lamar in the parish of Westmoreland, Southwest Jamaica. Kenyon has possession for Monroe. Manning spotting possession so far with 56% of it. But it's Monroe College with a football. Neil has it. Two waiting inside the box. Now the attempted cross, at least I think that's what it was. Too close to goalkeeper Ashoni Campbell. Manning Cup results coming in. St. Andrew Technical 0, Mona 0 in quarterfinal action. Set to replace in the semifinals. Yes, the winner of that one will be in the Manning Cup semifinals. Craig Butler, the coach of Mona High, trying to make good on his promise to win the Manning Cup this year. And Philip Williams, one of the most consistent coaches in Manning Cup within the last 5 years. Two finals, one semi-final. In fact, his results over the last three seasons have been second, third, second. In many ways, went into the 2019 Manning Cup final against Jamaica College as favourite. They had handsomely put away Jamaica College in the quarterfinal round in 2019, and they looked really strong heading there. Well, word coming in now from in Kingston that Mona, Craig Butler's Mona, have found the go-ahead goal. They now lead St. Andrew Technical by a goal to nil. So, Philip Williams, a lot of work to do. Did lead Jamaica College in this previous round of matches by 3-1, only to lose 5-3 to the Davion Ferguson outfit. And, of course, had they beaten Jamaica College, that would have confirmed their place. Their semi-final place. Now they have to be fighting for it, and they must come from behind. This one is big as well. As we get to the first water break, Monroe College and Manning locked at nil all after 22 and a half minutes. But it's been a game worth watching. You can clearly see that the Manning School, well-coached, quality players out on the park. And at Monroe College, they have quality as well. And they have one of the very best as far as schoolboy football coaches are concerned. This young man, Devonta Rodney, has been excellent for the Manning School. His speed, his skill, his crossing ability, his passing ability, Chris.
Yeah, we mentioned him earlier. Good on the right flank. Pacey and his close ball control. Very good. Look at that skill. Oh, that was lovely. Then cutting back onto the right foot. Very right-sided in his play, but his speed and trickery has been a problem for the Monroe team. That coming off the upright, very nearly snuck into the near post. He's only scored one goal this season, and in that situation, he might well have added a second. But creating opportunities for his teammates, hydration an important part, good to see drinking water. We spoke about that too, Ricardo, the fact that these youngsters don't hydrate enough.
Yeah. Devonta Rodney, 18 years old now, transferred from Brazil. Brazil's having a tremendous tradition as far as the Costa Cup football is concerned.
Brazil's the only team to take points off of Manning so far this season. It was a 2-2 draw when they met. That's the only blemish to their record, Manning.
So, you pointed out no goals, Chris, but 4 assists to his credit this season, Devonta Rodney, and you can see why.
Yeah, quality balls put into the 18-yard area from the wide areas. He started well. Manning won't mind this result. Well, Jackie Walters there in picture, as they said, has won so many titles. One at Camperdown back in the early 80s. He's won with Glenn Muir in the mid-2000s. Won with Clarendon College in the 90s as well.
1998. And then had to return to give Clarendon College their next title in 2014. Yep. 2006, 2012 with Glenmuir.
Yeah.
I think they won 2004 as well. Three titles to Glenmuir.
Yeah. That 2012 victory, a classic.
In a head-to-head clash with Omar Rambo Whittaburn and St. Elizabeth Technical in Montego Bay, coming off with a 1-0 victory. Has work to do here. He would love a 1-0 victory. Faulkner with the left foot. Oh, that's gone high. That's gone far. That's gone for six. Wrong sport. That would be excellent in the other version of football.
Rugby? Oh,
no, her American
the
football.
American version.
Yeah, that's what you would call a try. In football, it's a try as well. It's not a very good one. A lot of history to this Munro outfit. Just unfortunate as it hasn't been in recent time. Last title, 1964. Seven titles to their name. And in fact, the Costa Cup, which was named the Costa Cup in 1950, prior to that, because rural era football had been playing since 1912, the Munro College had actually won quite a few trophies between 1912 and 1950. They have not been looked at in the same way because it wasn't called the Costa Cup. Well, I might argue differently about that, but anyhow.
In those early years, it was pretty much just them winning.
Yeah, Commonwealth College did win a few in that time, and Mannings was around as well. Mannings, one of the oldest schools in Jamaica, in the English-speaking Caribbean, in fact.
Love how you say one of. There is a big debate and a continuous one about whether Mannings or Woolworths.
Yeah.
Is older,
and that's why I caught myself quickly. I can't remember the 2 years.
I'm glad you did. Even with all the information, you would struggle to come to a final determination.
One thing is for sure, it's between those two, as the longest serving schools in the English speaking Caribbean.
Mannings in possession. Jean-Twan McIntosh has the football, launches it upfield. Headed forward by Porter. Porter is looking for Hall. The Monroe College defense standing strong.
Here's a challenge. A real head collision, but both footballers protecting themselves well, avoiding injury. Tough sport, this game. You'd have to say it's really disappointing, considering the age of Mannings, that they have never lifted at a Costa Cup title. Not even in those early years where it was probably, what, four teams competing. They never managed a title.
They would love to deliver that this year. And you look at their team and you think they have every chance of doing so. Might have one Clarendon College to deal with, but they have enough quality out there based on what we've seen already to think that they could be genuine contenders.
Their best performance in any recent time coming in 2005, where they made it to the semi-final.
Here they are. With Shamar Hamilton firing that one inside. Former Jamaica under 15 player. Shamar Hamilton has scored a couple of goals this season. Has 5 assists to his credit as well. The Mannings number 10.
There he is. You mentioned top players. They had a really top play in 2005. I don't know if you remember the likes of Melvin Blair. Real standout for Mannings. Got to the semi-final, as I said. Lost to Glenmuir by 3-2. Right here at St. Elizabeth Technical, that match was played.
Glenmuir going on to lose to Gunfer Stewart. In the final,
yeah,
Gunfer Stewart going on to lose to Calabar in the Olivia Shield.
Oh, that's why you remember that so well.
Always, never forget. 30th minute of this contest. By this point, in the earlier game, we'd already seen 3 goals heading towards a 4th. None yet in this one, but this has been a very good game of high school football in the DaCosta Cup. Kenyon over it for Monroe. Looking for Faulkner. Headed away. Comes out to Hamilton. Ah, You're looking at two schools who are desperate to get to the promised land. First yellow card of the encounter. And it goes to Jevon Shariah, the 18-year-old centre-back for Monroe College. Shariah would have seen his old school make it to the Ben Francis knockout. That's very technical. And now he knows Monroe College already at least assured a Ben Francis place. But what they really want is a place in the Da Costa Cup semifinals. Free kick coming up for Hall. Bang. Gets it back. Rodney. Chapman Williams thought about it, decided against it. Loose pass and a throw coming up for Monroe College. The Manning School only need a draw to advance to the Da Costa Cup semi-finals. Monroe College have to win or else they'll have to settle for a place in the Ben Francis knockout, which these days you would have to look at as a secondary trophy considering the top teams in the Da Costa Cup, the top four, will not take part in that. Monroe College on the attack. Ball inside looking for Foster. Cross was not a very good one. In days gone by, Chris Taylor, this place would be rocking. You would be hearing vuvuzelas, chanting fans, packed. St. Elizabeth Technical, but we're living in a new age, in the COVID age, and things are very, very different. Graham, Hamilton, Manning's in possession. Graham. Rodney is up ahead. Now Kenyon has it for Monroe. Turns it forward. Cut out by champion Williams. And Manning have possession again. John Twan McIntosh. Shamar Hamilton. Porter, this is Porter, back to Hamilton, just one inside the box, goes for goal, and very easy for Henry James. Wallace lifts it over the top, looking for Rodney. Rodney has possession of the ball. Edge of the box, Rodney goes down, and it's going to be a free kick for the Manning School. He's already proving to be a handful, and he wins the free kick in a very dangerous area of the park. What can Manning make from this? Here's another look at it. Javon Lewis. Nowhere near the ball, but he stopped the man. And that was the important thing in that play. McIntosh standing over it. Celebrated his 18th birthday yesterday, Jean-Antoine McIntosh. Two assists this season, looking looking for a third, not there. Monroe's ball. Manning School, 278 years old, Chris. Only one month older.
Yeah, second. Just checking the statistics. 278 in 2016, so at 5, 283 years old now. Manning. Almost has the edge.
So many years, no Da Costa Cup titles, looking for a first one. Monroe. Yvonne Fletcher, the 16-year-old, unable to keep it in play. Played in the Super League at just 15 years old, Yvonne Fletcher. Shamar Hamilton for Manning. Possession lost. Foster has it. Faulkner's in an offside position. Didn't get to him in any case. Free kick coming up for Monroe.
Big news coming in from Manchester. Dinty have scored. Dinty lead William Nil. Dinty lead Edwin Allen, sorry, by a goal to nil. The winner of that, a semi-final spot. Dintil 1, Edwin Allen 0. First half action.
Of course, it would be somewhat of a surprise to see Edwin Allen in the Da Costa Cup semi-finals. No surprise to see Dintil there if they do get there. Faulkner turns, can't get the shot away. At it again, no luck. Daniel Bowen, the 16-year-old, he's a big 16-year-old, Daniel Bowen, recovering well. Rodney, look at the ease. Which he moves the ball and moves with it. Now Wallace. Throw coming up for the Manning School. Oh, that. And that wasn't far away. Approaching half time.
In case you're just wondering, Dintil leading Edwin Allen by a goal to nil. That match being played at Draxhall. I know I said Manchester earlier, it's actually at Draxhall.
I wondered about that.
In St. Anne.
McIntosh in possession. Finds Hamilton.
Can you just imagine fans trying to make their way to have a look. Wow. They'll be on the wrong highway.
Monroe College making it that more difficult for the Manning School to get into those dangerous positions in the last 10 minutes or so. They're always looking for the Devontae Bosney. Now it comes to Jamara Hall. They have a lot of players who can find the back of the net. The Manning School. Here is Rashawn Graham. Forced to shoot from distance and it's wide of the mark. As we approach the 41st minute in this quarterfinal encounter, Manning will not be too bothered. Neither will coach Charles Tomlinson. All they need is a draw to advance to the semifinals. But they know that once it is at nil all, they're always in danger. Here's a neat ball tapped inside looking for Porter. That's cut out. Sturdy defending coming from the Monroe team. Comes out to Neil for them. They have to find a goal, Monroe College. Fought the fighting for it. And the partner commits the infringement. Athena, what is going down? And a free kick inside their own half for the Manning School. Ian Faulkner, 5 goals to his credit, the Monroe College number 17. Nice ball played on. Porter went down.
A lot of persons have always wondered, based on Manning's age, if the actual urban era competition, the Manning Cup, was named after them. I just want to clarify that it was not. Manning Cup was actually named after Sir William Henry Manning, who was the governor of the island at the time in 1910 or 12. And that's who the Manning Cup was named after. Manning's was named after Thomas Manning, who was an English scholar, sinologist actually by profession, and European scholar who had a lot to do with Chinese studies. The first around at the time lived in the 18th and 19th century. It's just a coincidence, the name, the last name.
Approaching halftime in this, the Costa Cup quarterfinal encounter. Quarterfinal round encounter. And it's pretty much a virtual quarterfinal. The winner here advances to the semifinals. Omar Rambo Wedderburn has won this trophy before, but he finds himself in a sticky position this season with St. Elizabeth Technical. They have one match to go. They are level on points with Garvin Maceo. But Garvin Maceo has sent Thomas Technical to play. And many believe Garvin Maceo should advance. St. Thomas Technical beaten 6-1 by Stets, I think 9-2 by Froome Technical. And Stets will have Froome Technical to play tomorrow. Garvin Maceo will have St. Thomas Technical. So they are favoured to get through. But they still have to get out there and score the goals. And Stets will be looking to get the better of Froome Technical, hopefully, by scoring enough to take them through. That's going to be on Saturday.
Half-time in the Manning Cup in Kingston. Jamaica College and St. Catherine High locked at nil-all. Jamaica College have already qualified for the semifinals. Mona still leading St. Andrew Technical after 45 minutes by a goal to nil.
Two Manning Cup semifinalists to be decided at the end of today. Same for the DaCosta Cup. The remaining semifinalists to be finalized on Saturday. Manning's in possession, looking for Rodney. Good control of the football. Oh, does brilliantly, Devontae Rodney. And he's on his way. Two inside the box. But he's not going to get it to any of them. Good recovery from the Monroe College backline. But this man is wreaking havoc. Devontae Rodney.
Actually looked to do a step over and made contact with the heel And that's why he actually gave up possession, but did well to win it back. Very quick, good, nifty footwork. Rodney, look at that strength. Not very big in stature, but lovely turn just to shrug off his opponent. And that was where he was looking to do the step over. But to give him credit, he did fight back for the ball and has won a free kick. 2 minutes of time to be added at the end of this first half. Rodney with the free kick. It's a good one. The header is just over. There goes an opportunity for Mannings to go in front. And for Rodney to have his fifth assist of the season. What a delivery into the box. Most watering. Good attempt. It was Porter who got the header. Jamalik Porter, who himself has scored 5 goals and provided 5 assists. There seems to be a pretty good chemistry between himself and Rodney as well. They've looked for each other quite a bit. Obviously, usually it's Rodney looking for him because he's playing in the wide area. But yes, a good opportunity. Lovely delivery into the box yet again. Less than a minute to play. Shantone McIntosh. Still no goals in this quarterfinal round encounter. Wallace. Flank stays down. And he's going through. Oh, that's a brilliant save, was it? Jamara Hall. Here's another look at it. Lovely turn from Hall. And fighting his way through and producing the save out of Henry James, not for the first time in this first half.
The amazing thing to me was a save by James. Very good hands, James. It was a well-struck shot by Hall. Snapshot, not a heavy backlift, but great power. Good save by James.
Showing why he's the leading goal scorer for them this season with 7. McIntosh with the corner. And it's headed behind. Will be a goal kick. Won't have time for it though. The first half. An entertaining finish to what has been a really good game of the Costa Cup football. Mannings have threatened. They have pushed. And they have created chances. They have been unable to take any of them. And at halftime, Monroe College still hanging in there. They need to win, Monroe. It's nil all at the end of the first 45 minutes. It's still all to play for at St. Elizabeth Technical High come the second 45.
Boy football, the Costa Cup action. We're in Santa Cruz at the St. Elizabeth Technical High School, and it's Mannings High nil, Monroe College nil after 45 minutes. Let's have a look at those highlights. Mannings in the navy blue, Monroe coming forward, white tops, aggressive at first, strike here, weak attempt, and easily covered by goalkeeper Beckford. Intense affair. This man has been a real standout for the Mannings School thus far. Some good opportunities and nearly added his second of the season. And a good attempt by young Devontae Rodney. Continuing to come forward, Mannings have been the better of the play. Here was a delicious ball into the box from a free kick from Devontae Rodney again. Should have been converted by Porter, who has 5 for the season. And then this from Hall. Great strength to get through. Good footwork. And a lovely snapshot. But Henry James was too good in goal. And made sure Monroe didn't concede an 11th goal this season. saw some 8 shots from Mannings. They've been on the front foot, 2 on target, just 1 on target from Monroe from their 2 attempts. So 13 fouls. Monroe have been busy trying to win the ball from Mannings so far. And 3 saves between the 2 keepers. Henry James making the most of them with 2. And Mannings have the majority of the possession. But after 45 minutes, it's Mannings nil, Monroe nil. A result, or I should say a scoreline that Mannings would rather. All they need is a draw to go through. Coming up on the home of champions. Great action coming up in the second half of this encounter between Mannings High School and Monroe College. She's locked at nil all. Winner of this, of course, to go through to the semi-final of the DaCosta Cup 2021. Mannings only need a draw, so as it stands, this will favour them. Let's have a look at the standings as it stands. Live, Mannings would qualify with 7 points if the result remains the same. As you can see, that one draw, Monroe would be in second with 5 points. They would qualify for the Ben Francis Cup along with their technical, who qualified earlier this afternoon with a defeat of Happy Grove by 4-3. So this will suit Mannings. Monroe need to push players forward. They're going to make a substitution as well, Monroe. It will be Giovanni Foster. Giovanni Foster to come on. Actually, Giovanni Foster will be coming off. And it will be Zaria Bruce to come on. A 2-goal man this season. There he is wearing the number 9. And as we said, Monroe need goals. Hence the insertion of Bruce. He can make a difference, Chris. He has the ability to make a difference. We've already seen it once this season. In a television match, that was against St. Elizabeth Technical when he came on in the second half, at the start of the second half, with a goal and an assist. And teams up really well with Cian Faulkner. So let's see how that partnership goes this afternoon. It will need to click if Monroe College are to get victory here and advance to the DaCosta Cup semi-finals. So there's confirmation. Zaria Bruce is on. Only 2 fluent scorers in this Monroe team. Faulkner with 5 and Sean Kenyon, your favourite, with 5 as well. So goal scoring has been a struggle at times for Monroe. Only 6 scorers within their squad. Their squad has quite a few players in it. Over 20. Of course, the year Bruce will know these grounds here very well. Transferred from St. Elizabeth Technical to Monroe College. So he would have been extra motivated in that game against it. If you look at the infringement that has led to the free kick coming up for the Manning School. They are already in the driver's seat, Mannings, but if they can get a goal here, it will put them further in charge because they only need a draw. Free kick taken, almost landed on the boot of Rashawn Graham. And a timely header away coming from Javon Shariah. And a corner kick coming up for the Manning School. They cut off of the blocks quickly in the first half. They will want to do the same here at the start of the second. Corner kick to the near post. Headed behind for another one. McIntosh. Again with the corner. Oh, that actually sneaked across goal. For a second, I thought it had gone behind. Wallace for Mannings. to give it right back with Hamilton. Hamilton cuts inside the box and gets across in. Well handled. Hamilton again. Lovely turn and the cut is brilliant and the header is wide. Jamara Hall, the 18-year-old, with the header. Lovely, they operate from the wide areas, Mannings. Shamar Hamilton this time on the left-hand flank. The captain, lovely delivery into the box. Spectacular from Hall, but needed to be lower. Their leading goal scorer this season, Jamara Hall, with 7 goals. Transferred from Little London High School in 2019. Remember a few seasons ago, Little London had a good team in the Da Costa Cup. Did fairly well, got deep. But coach Everton Tomlinson has really done his work, gotten in quality to build on what he already had. And here they are, the Manning School, making a serious run at the Da Costa Cup title. Rashawn Graham. Now with Rashid. Good challenge coming in over on the far side to thwart that attack from the Manning School. Still awaiting the opening goal. Tight affair this one. The Manning School, the more expressive of the two. Created chances towards the end of the first half as we look at the challenge coming in from Devon Fletcher. Oof. Free kick for Manning. Well, there's one thing they haven't looked too good at today, that's shooting from distance. Athena Wallace's shot well over the top. They could do it one. Miller. Tevon Miller on their team. Would be a great addition. He wears a bit of blue as well. Monroe College. Zaire Bruce. The very dangerous Zaire Bruce. Seeing the flag. Tevon Miller and Jaheim Thomas. Two of the best kickers of the football we've seen this season. I do remember Jaheim Thomas from the Edwin Allen unit. They are battling still for a place in the semi-finals with Dintil Technical. Dintil still lead by a goal, but goal to nil. Tayamba Chin, the scorer of that goal, their number 8. Manning searching for their goal. Bodney gives it away. Rear poor pass. Gets your picked it up for Monroe. They're on their way. Ball over the top for Faulkner. Faulkner does well to get a head onto it, but couldn't maintain possession of the ball. Keeping you updated on all the action from around the country. In the Manning Cup, Jamaica College, the defending champions, have scored a goal. They now lead St. Catherine Higher by a goal to nil. They've already qualified for the semi-finals, but trying to have a 3-win record in the quarter-final rounds. Mona, they continue to lead. Mona continue to lead Stats. St. Andrew Technical by a goal to nil. Kenelda Brown, the scorer of that goal there, dangerous. Number 7, Kenelda Brown for Mona. All has it for Manning. Clear down for Monroe. Play continues. With effort. Jamal Hall. 7 goals to his credit this season. Once. An 8th goal there. Shamar Hamilton, the 17-year-old, has scored twice. He's played for the National Under 15 team. As well, Shamar Hamilton showing some of that quality this afternoon. It's become a much tighter game, this. Patrick Jackie Walters will know that just one goal near the death will sneak them into the semi-finals. So it's not a comfortable affair for Manning by any stretch of the imagination. Of course, a goal would make it a lot more difficult for Monroe, who would need then 2 goals. But once it stays like this, Jackie Walters will know that one opportunity for Monroe and they're in. Chaplin pulling up, centered inside the box. Headed on. Graham trying to shoot. And it will be a corner kick coming up for the Manning School. No matter what happens at the end of this one, of course you can watch all schoolboy football action this season on the Sportsmax app. There you go. The best of both worlds. He gets to hear wonderful commentary, and he can watch it on screen and live. It doesn't get much better than that. Corner kick coming up for the Manning School. It's a good one as well. They've had very good deliveries inside the box. Back to the back post. Still unable to break through. The school from Stefano Lemar. The 283-year-old school. From the parish of Westmoreland. Under the coach of the tutelage of Charles Tomlinson. Looking to repeat the efforts of 2005 and maybe even go better, where they made it to the semi-finals with Melvin Blair and company, before losing 3-2 to Glenn Muir right here at St. Elizabeth Technical. Can they get to the semi-finals once again? Can Blair Bruce reproduce the quality of performance he did against St. Elizabeth Technical here this season to send Monroe into the Costa Cup semi-finals? Instead. No matter what happens at the end of this one, Chris, one of these teams will be left heartbroken. As it is now, they are both so close. Jamaica College now leading by 2-0 over St. Catherine. St. Catherine turning out to be the whipping boys of that quarterfinal bomb group. That would be their third defeat. St. Catherine. But they'll have a chance to defend their Walker Cup title. Yes, they will. The third and fourth place teams of the two Manning Cup zones will contest the Walker Cup. So they definitely will. Well, another team that suffered three losses this season, William Nip, they went down by 3-2 to Christiana in an early encounter. And here's an interesting fact. William Nip have not beaten any team from outside the parish of Trelawney this season. They've lost to Holland. They've lost to Edwin Allen, and they would have lost to Dintill.
Yeah. You mean outside of Zone A? Because obviously Cornwall College, they defeated Cornwall College and they're in St. James.
Well, yes, Cornwall, the only team there. Holland would have beaten them.
Yeah, they also played Herbert Morrison. As far as I remember, they defeated Herbert Morrison as well. One loss in the zone, and it came to the at the hands of Holland. Their noisy neighbors. But yes, outside of Zone A, they haven't been able to win a match. And since that loss to Holland, it has certainly changed the momentum. It changed the momentum of their season. Not had it. Their season is now over. But it totally changed their momentum. That 1-0 defeat at the hands of Holland.
Yeah. Well, they've only beaten teams from the parish of St. James. Is the point I was trying to make. Yeah. All their wins have been St. James teams. They've lost all their other matches. Teams outside of St. James. Including Holland.
News coming in from the, well, as we see an infringement here and a yellow card to Devon Fletcher. Yeah. St. Andrew Technical.
We keep coming up with a good one. Headed over the top door.
Offside.
Yeah.
St. Andrew Technical have equalized against Mona. It's now 1-1 in second half action in Kingston. That's a big match. Really big. Winner of that will join Jamaica College in the semi-finals.
Mona needs to win, don't they?
Yes.
Because St. Andrew Technical would have gone into that game with a better goal difference. Did they? Let's do a quick check on that, because that's going to be critical. Critical here as well, because the Manning School only need a draw to advance. And Monroe College getting ready to make a second substitution. Tristan Ford is off, replaced by Jamal Bacchus.
Okay, so just listening in, didn't tell you. Edwin Allen by a 4-0 at the Traxall Stadium. That's the other, the Costa Cup match. William Nib went down 3-2 to Christiana, who booked their place into the Costa Cup, in the Ben Francis Cup. Christiana. Jamaica College, they currently lead St. Catherine by 2-0 and are about to complete a clean sweep of that group, winning all three games. St. Andrew Technical and Mona locked at one apiece, and St. Andrew Technical have a superior goal difference. They have a one goal differential, and Nero and Mona are all square. So that's very tight in itself. The odd goal would create something very interesting. So one goal, the difference between the positions in Group 1 of the Manning Cup. Of
course, St. Catherine at the bottom with no points. If it stays like this here at St. Elizabeth Technical, Monroe will be out of the Da Costa Cup, as will Patrick Jackie Walters. They need to win this to advance. Mannings only need a draw. And they are doing what they need to do to this point. The other way. Monroe getting ready for another substitution. It's Devon Fletcher who will be taken out. And replaced by Alphonse Troop. Who got the header? And Manning's in control now. We'll just make a check to and who got that final touch for the Manning's goal. Abina Wallace with his fifth goal of the season. defending Mannings in front in this quarterfinal round contest. And now Monroe College have it all to do.
What a goal it was for Wallace as well. Athena Wallace, the Mannings number 7. Fifth goal of the season for this man. Here he is. Fifth goal. Even more problems, as you mentioned, Ricardo, for Monroe, because now they're going to need 2 goals, struggling to even score 1. And I guess the plan that Patrick Walters might have had has now backfired with that goal.
Yeah, they haven't really created any. Rodney has possession. Cheeky from Devonte Rodney. Monroe College also getting ready to make a 4th substitution.
Interesting stuff in the Manning Cup as we take a look at the substitution here for Monroe, who have to go for Broke at this point. Mona, who were leading St. Andrew Technical by a goal to nils, of course it starts equalizing, are now down to 9 men, Mona. So discipline seeking in there, 9 men. Well, quite difficult now for them to contain a talented St. Andrew Technical attack. And Philip Williams, who has a lot of experience at the schoolboy level and a lot of success as well in terms of getting to the semi-final round, must be thinking his chances have heightened. I wonder how many push-ups are being done in that contest. There is your goal scorer, Athena Wallace. His 5th of the season, and surely one of the most important, taking Manning that much closer to the semi-finals of the Da Costa Cup. And what a goal it was. They had been delivering quality crosses all afternoon, and it was only a matter of time before one of them was headed on target. Here's another look at it. Lovely delivery into the box, and look at that. Look at how he rose for that ball, Wallace. A tall person by any means, but got up well. Good basketball jump there, Ricardo. And just that glancing header. We've seen opportunities to head on target before, and all of them were headed over. This one, Wallace made sure he headed downwards. He got above the ball instead of underneath it. And as I said, no surprise that the goal coming from something from the wide areas, which they've shown so much quality.
Sean Graham with the corner kick. Athena Wallace with the header on. 1-0 for Manning.
There you saw the likes of Sean Kenyon, who really has a lot of work to do. He hasn't been, maybe it's one of your favourites, Ricardo, but really hasn't had the impact that you'd have wanted to see from him, or Monroe would have wanted to see so far this afternoon. He still does have time, but it's been a real quiet afternoon for the Monroe number 10.
It has been a quiet afternoon for any attacking-minded player on the Monroe team. Not just Sean Kenyon. Zaire Bruce has come on at halftime, and he's been missing. Faulkner.
5 goal man this season.
Has clearly seen the ball.
I think he's seen the goal.
Yeah, it's been a tough afternoon for Monroe College. And you just don't see them scoring 2. It was going to be difficult to get 1, but once it remained at nil all,
With the experience of Jackie Walters, they could have snuck out something in the dying stages, but yes, I agree with it. 2 goals looking improbable against this Manning's outfit. Well, only conceded, what, some 4 goals in the first round, 2 so far, so 6 overall in the entire season of 8 games they have played. This is their 9th. Of course, Rashawn Graham, their number 11 with that assist, is now the leading assist maker in the team with 6. That's the man we were talking about with his assist to number 11, getting a hard challenge there. It's a player who is off the field, or Ricardo. Looks like the captain, Shamar Hamilton, who is struggling. Far side. Cramp again, as we've seen so much this season. Free kick coming up for the Manning School. The goal scorer, Avina Wallace, standing over it. Totally agree. I love the pace to their attacks, Marlins. Really transition very well, very quickly. Not big players by any means, but speedy. And a lot of nifty footwork as well. A unit that have a really good balance of experience and, well, youth. I guess all of them are young, but under 14 and under 16 players making up the squad, but about 6 or 7 players, as we look at the opportunity, which was wide, 6 or 7 of these players were a part of the 2019 team that did well, that got to the quarterfinal round and really caused a lot of problems. Kenyon, what can he do? Lifts it inside to keep for Bruce. Oh, Bruce does well. Zahir Bruce, the attempted cross, was looking for Stephon Davis. This moment brought to you by the Sportsmax app. Don't miss a moment. Download the Sportsmax app for live sports all the time. Watch anytime, anywhere, on any device, including casting to your television set. The goal that has put Manning's in front in this crucial quarterfinal round encounter, scored by Abina Wallace from a pitch of a corner kick from Rashawn Graham. Download it now. All the schoolboy football matches like you're seeing there on Sportsmax Plus. It's free. Don't have to pay a cent. Makes sense. Free kick coming up for Monroe College. The captain, Sean Kenyon, standing over it. Hasn't been his best day. Comes out to Daniel Bowen. Monroe need to find something here. Bruce. Just not moving the ball quickly enough. Monroe College, Faulkner. Chips it over the top looking for Bruce. Too much weight on it. And Monroe still have it all to do here in Santa Cruz. Hall. Now with Devonta Rodney. Rodney gets across in. Head it away. Hamilton, the captain, picks it up. Goes for the target. Wide. Skillful bunch, Mullins. As you said, nifty footwork there. It's from the captain, Hamilton. Shot always wide. Interesting to see where they do come up against a very physical opponent that is a lot bigger in stature. How they will manage that, Mullins. As news coming in from the Manning Cup is that Jamaica College have now extended their lead. 3-0 their lead. St. Catherine High. And looking to do just what Mullins are doing here. A complete sweep of the quarter-final round of their group. Jamaica College, among the first to book their semi-final spots in the Manning Cup. Nothing secured yet in the Da Costa Cup, but it could be here as Porter surges forward. And well defended. Jamalee Porter, 5 to his credit this season. But just wasn't given the time of day. Good work initially by Daniel Bowen. And then getting some assistance from Shariah. Undefeated so far this season, Mullins. Really been a top performance by this team. Following up on their 2019 exploits where they got to the quarter-final round, looking to do one better now. And it seems like they're going to accomplish that. Well, we are set for some cracking the Costa Cup semi-finals, I think. Bruce. Very few options, though. Holds up well now. To Kenyon trying to love the goalkeeper well wide of the mark. It hasn't been his best day for sure.
That's a good idea by Kenyon. Had that been on target, I think he might have scored.
On another day, it might have been on target.
Yeah, I think Campbell was in some problems. He was in no man's land, Campbell. I think the defenders are pointing that out to him as well. Had Kenyon made a better connection, he would have been in business. The trajectory was good, the direction was off.
Pressure. Big pressure match this. And the Mannings boys have handled it brilliantly.
This man has been excellent in the wide areas. Here he goes again. It's almost like he can't get tired.
Hey, Rodney. He's an entertainer. He's calling for it, Rodney. Wallace.
Very small in stature, but strong on the ball, Rodney. Look at this skill here. Cuts it back and then gives them the merry-go-round as well. Might have been dizzy after that.
The defender? bad delivery from the wide area. Dintel still with a nip by a goal to nil. That would confirm their place as Group 1 winners. Dintel Technical. Both those teams are on 6 points coming into that match. Being played at Drax Hall in St. Anne. So at this stage, the Manning School and Dintel Technical will play each other in the semi-final. That should be a fabulous semi-final. The other semi-final, quite likely to be Cannon College and Dartmouthshire Park Corner. Sorry, almost getting through on goal. That pronunciation sounds very fancy. I was wondering if you were South American. Out of Colombia. Uruguay are one of those teams. Too late to take you on this. Another card coming out here. And it goes to a chance of truth, the substitute. I look forward to seeing Mannings again though. That's for sure. Full time, Mona 1, St. Andrew Technical 1. So stats into the Manning Cup semi-finals again. 4-4. But nearly able to control with the head that time. Impressive performance by Philip Williams and his troops. Initially not a part of the quarter-final round, and with the expulsion of Campadone and Tivoli getting in, and they've certainly made the most of the opportunity. 4 years in a row they've gotten to the semi-finals. Of course, Craig Butler, unable to fulfill his promise of winning the Manning Cup this season, but in truth, I think there are many good things about that Mona team and program, and if he continues in 2 to 3 seasons, they could be a genuine force. I never thought they would genuinely challenge for the title this year, but there is a lot there for the future. These are good things at Mona, certainly. Their style of play, a personality about them. Mona hasn't been a team that have really done much in the Manning Cup. A lot of persons transition from that school to other schools as well, but he's been able to put some quality together there, and I agree with you, the years to come, if he's there, Mona couldn't really start to give a lot of trouble. Well, they have given a lot of trouble, but even more trouble. So kudos to him on what I would say, based on Mona's performances over the years, a successful season for sure. Jamalee Porta, Manning School. Time running out at Monroe College. Thank you. He had been sleeping all along, Sean Kenyon. And that's a top strike. Just the vision, just the look up from Kenyon. Look at that power. Amazing. Short back lift. It's amazing that he could generate such power. Great technique by the number 10. You've been speaking about him from the start of the game. Quiet right route. And he did give a hint about 10 minutes ago where he tried to lock the keeper and was off the mark. But there was nothing that was inaccurate about that strike. Sixth goal of the season for Sean René Francois Delano St. Aubin Kenyon. As Paul the Kibble, my name's Francois. Yep. Well, of course, result as it is, it's still Mannings to go through. But if Monroe could sneak something else, Patrick McAvalter's finger things are shake of the head from him. He feels they've let it go, but there are 4 minutes to play. Can they create something else? That came out of nowhere. And you're right, Chris, he had given a warning just a few minutes earlier when he might have put that one away. And it was just a slight look up from him on that occasion. Great thinking. Shows that he's an intelligent player, Kenyon. You spoke about that as well at the start of the game, how his versatility as a player, depending on the role that Jackie Walters asked him to play. But just the instinct, just that slight look up. I leave it so late though, Kenyon. Sean Graham standing behind the ball. Cricket for Mannings. They will want to win this one. Have a 100% win record in the quarterfinal round. Henry James watches in goal, and that's not a bad hit, but no pace on it. The goalkeeper almost letting it go. 4 minutes at it. Frantic finish here in Santa Cruz. Sean Kenny and Chris twice given trial stints with the national on the 15 and on the 17 teams. Has not made the final cut. And that shot didn't make the final cut either. But yeah, he certainly has ability. What I would question is, as you said, he's been so dormant for, 85 minutes. I mean, a quality player does pop up at the right time, but still, he needs to impact the game more. Free kick for Monroe College. So maybe the reason he got to the trial was because they saw stints of what he can do. Little aspects, little glimpses, which he just showed us. But over 90 minutes, maybe he needs to do more. It was much better over 90 minutes in that game against Tech, but again, an even bigger match this for a place in the semi-finals. Yes, 2 minutes to play. And it's the Manning School with the football. Mannings are in no hurry, and they need not be. Cricket for the Mannings School. Shamara Hall. That over the top. The footman, a little longer. High schooler. Kenyon. Looking for Bruce. Mannings are well aware of what they need to do, not concede another goal. Seconds to go. Monroe fighting. Mannings holding. Ball over the top. Too much on it for Bruce to get there. And it's punched in
to touch for a Monroe College throw, which they will want to take quickly. Seconds away from the final whistle. Monroe College need to get the ball inside the box quickly. They do get it inside. Comes out to Faulkner. He isn't sure where it is. And Manning's defending Salty. And that may well be it. It's a throw for Monroe, but they have to do it very, very quickly. The attempted cross charge down. Kenyon fighting for it. Can he deliver across? Gets a corner kick, but how much time do they have to take it, Chris Taylor?
They don't have any.
It's their first corner of the match. Can there be greater meaning at the end of it?
Kenyon to take it.
Needs a quality delivery to the near post and pushed behind. And the Manning School are into the semi-finals of the Lacosta Cup. That is what it means to them. They have been very good. They remain unbeaten in the competition this season. Two wins and now a draw in the second round.
Training, so I guess it's braveness because no one didn't want to jump, so I just go up there and say, I'm gonna pick it up from a team and do it. Well, your entire team is here to hear your interview. What do you have to say to them? What's the celebration going to be like?
Well, it's great. Well, I'm saying we glad to reach the semi-final. It's been years now, Manning's never had done this. So it's a great feeling.
Well, congratulations to you, and we look forward to seeing you in the semi-final.
Thank you, sir.
Excellent stuff. Albina Wallace scoring the sixth of the season. And now we're going to invite Coach Charles Tomlinson to come in. Charles, what a performance by your man in school, 283 years old. And in the semi-finals for what, second time in some 16 years? How do you feel?
It's a good feeling. I am happy that we have made it this far, and we're looking to make progression all the way.
What has been the key to this team throughout the season? A team that hasn't lost all season.
I think it's the dedication of the players. They listen, they follow instruction, and as you see, they are going from strength to strength. So I am proud, happy to be their coach, and I will have them continue working hard all the way to the final.
Excellent stuff. We look forward to seeing you in the semifinals. Congrats to you and your team, and rest well.
Yes, and I want to take this opportunity to commend Monroe. I think Jackie has done a good job, and the spirit of the game, both teams play with the spirit of the game, and that I want to commend them, and I wish Issa and the rest of the schools all the best going forward. Thank you very much.
Thank you. All the best to you as well. Patrick, Jackie Walters coming to the mic now. Jackie, a good performance by Monroe. Yes, you would have loved to have made it through to the semi-finals, but a pretty good performance and then a good fight towards the end of this match.
Yes, but first I must congratulate Mannings. I think they deserve to win the game. They play some real quality football. Yeah, and all of us far too late. But again, I must congratulate them. They deserve to be there.
Talk to me about this Monroe unit. It's been a bit of an up-and-down performance so far this season, a bit inconsistent at times.
Right.
What do you think alluded to that?
Well, actually, the background preparation was not there because of the COVID, you know. And I think it manifested itself throughout the season. So I think that was the main cause of our up-and-down performance.
The season's not yet done. You're not going through to the Costa Cup semi-finals, but you're going to be a part of the Ben Francis. You're a man that wins a lot of titles, Jackie. Are you looking forward to that one, and what can we see in store for Monroe?
Well, most definitely, you know, we are going to prepare ourselves. You know, we have like a break, which is critically important for us. And we are looking forward to the Ben Francis.
So are we. All the best to you. Congratulations on what would have been, I think, a successful season, even though you haven't got through. And we look forward to seeing you in the Ben Francis and good performances from Monroe College.
Thank you very much.
Well, thank you very much, Coach Patrick Jackie Walters. There you have it. Their technical beating Happy Grove by 4-3. Mannings and Monroe College ending 1-1. Leaving the table looking like this. Mannings through to the DaCosta Cup semi-finals with 7 points. Monroe College finishing second on 5 points. They will play the Ben Francis Cup along with their technical, who finished third in the group, Happy Grove. Well, that's it for them this season, finishing in fourth position on 1 point. Just one match on Saturday. St. Elizabeth the Technical taking on Froome Technical. That match on Sportsmax 2 and the Sportsmax Plus pregame show at 12:30 p.m., 1:30 Eastern Caribbean time. Well, that's it from Santa Cruz, St. Elizabeth Technical High School. A glorious day for the Manning School through to the semifinals of the DaCosta Cup. Their technical came here, got 4 goals, 3 points, and they will play the Ben Francis along with Monroe College on behalf of